Squatting toilets have been the traditional method of defecation for thousands of years in many cultures worldwide. Squatting toilets offer several advantages, such as straightening the rectum by relaxing the puborectalis muscle, making defecation easier and reducing strain. The puborectalis muscle is a U-shaped muscle that wraps around the rectum, forming a slight bend, anorectal angle. This bend acts as a natural kink in the rectum, helping to maintain continence, the ability to control bowel movements. When a person sits on a regular toilet, the puborectalis muscle remains partially contracted, keeping the anorectal angle at around 80 to 90 degrees. This creates resistance, making it harder to pass stool and potentially leading to straining. Straining during bowel movements can lead to problems like hemorrhoids and fissures, and even pelvic floor dysfunction. Modern toilets, while convenient, force us into a seated position that is not ideal for bowel movements. In a squatting posture, the thighs press against the abdomen, which naturally relaxes the puborectalis muscle. This relaxation straightens the anorectal angle to about 100 to 110 degrees, allowing for a clearer path for stool to exit. As a result, less effort is needed, reducing the risk of constipation, hemorrhoids, and straining. In many cultures, squatting toilets use water instead of toilet paper, which some consider more hygienic. In squat toilets, your body doesn't touch the toilet surface at all. This reduces the risk of skin contact with germs, bacteria, or viruses left by previous users, especially in public restrooms. It's considered more hygienic in places where many people use the same toilet, as cross-contamination is less likely. On the other hand, in a squatting posture, splashing or poor aim can result in waste material landing on the floor or surrounding area, making the space messy and harder to keep clean. In some designs, flushing mechanisms are manual or less effective, which can leave visible residue and make the experience unpleasant. Users may come into indirect contact with waste, especially in high traffic or poorly maintained public toilets. Sitting toilets, on the other hand, are more comfortable for most people, especially for longer use. They require less effort than squatting, which can be challenging for some individuals. Sitting toilets are better suited for the elderly, pregnant women, people with mobility issues, and those with joint pain. Many modern designs incorporate bidets, self-cleaning features, and touchless flushing for better hygiene, reducing direct contact with waste. Nowadays, the best approach is to blend the best aspects of both types, optimizing for comfort, accessibility, and health. Using a specially designed toilet stool, also known as a defecation posture modification device, DPMD, can help you get into the ideal position for pooping. It lifts the feet to the optimal height, typically around 7 to 9 inches, straightens the anorectal angle, and makes bowel movements smoother, easier, and more complete. This can minimize straining, which is beneficial for preventing conditions like hemorrhoids, anal fissures, pelvic organ prolapse, and urinary incontinence, especially relevant to females. While you can repurpose a simple footstool or household item to elevate your feet, it may not provide the ideal height or angle for everyone. This can limit its effectiveness compared to a device specifically designed for proper toilet posture. Ultimately, understanding how posture affects bowel health empowers us to make small changes that can lead to major improvements in comfort, hygiene, and long-term well-being. Also, ergonomic design research could further optimize the sitting toilet for natural bowel movements, which would be a valuable innovation.